गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द चैप्टर 7 दैट इज स्टाफ मोटिवेशन एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द अर्लियर वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मैस्लोज थ्योरी ऑफ ह्यूमन नीड्स एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मैस्लोज फाइव डिस्टिंक्ट कैटेगरीज ऑल्सो. नाउ एज पर द रिड्यूस सिलेबस वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द assumption of the Maslow's theory and the criticisms. So the first assumption of human theory for Maslow's theory of human needs, it's classified into five distinct theories and five distinct categories. As we have stated that Maslow's theory has been defined into theories that human limited wants are of various types and it cannot be fulfilled. There are some sorts of needs which needs to be fulfilled at the beginning, then it moves to another. So there are also five categories which have been divided. There are lower level, then there are higher level needs. So it's written here that the human needs can be classified into distinct categories that we have discussed, the lower level and the higher level needs. And the into five levels we have done, that is physiological needs. Physiological means the bare or survival needs, food, clothing, shelter, then moves to the safety or security, that is economic and physical security. Then these are the lower level needs, then we move to the higher level needs, that is social needs, esteem needs and self-actualization needs. So first is human needs. Assumptions of Maslow's theory is human needs can be classified into distinct categories, distinct theories, and five distinct categories. There are five distinct categories which we have discussed this before. And next assumption of Maslow's theory is that a person can fulfill one need at a time. A person cannot fulfill various needs at a time. So person, if they want to fulfill, they can fulfill first the basic needs, the survival needs, that is physiological needs. So a person attempts to satisfy one category of needs at a time. They cannot fulfill the multiple needs at the same time. So a person attempts to satisfy one category of needs at a time, and therefore once lower level needs are fulfilled, then the person moves or climbs to the another level. If the physiological needs are satisfied, then the person moves to the security needs or safety needs. So this wants to convey the meaning that a person attempts to satisfy one need at a time. If the person have satisfied the second need, that is safety and security, then the person can move to the social needs. So a person attempts to satisfy one category of needs at a time, and once the lower level needs are satisfied, then the person can climb the ladder and move to the next need. So this is this satisfied need. Then the assumption of Maslow's theory of human needs states that once the needs are satisfied, be it any need, be it your physiological need, be it your safety needs, once the need is satisfied, that specific need does not motivate the persons, does not influence the persons. So once the need has been satisfied, that's take the example physiological need, food, clothing, shelter are very much satisfied, fulfilled, so it cannot motivate the person for that specific physiological needs. So the person, that specific need will cease or stop to be a motivating factor. So it's written here, a satisfied need no longer influence motivations. So it will no longer motivate and inspire people to work harder for that specific need. So it's written there, satisfied need no longer influences motivations. It ceases and stops motivating. And the next assumption of Maslow's theory of human needs, that until the lower level needs are not satisfied, the higher needs remain inactive. So this assumption states that until the lower level needs are physiological needs, safety needs. So these are the lower level needs. Until these needs are fulfilled and satisfied, a person cannot fulfill their social needs, esteem needs or self-actualization needs. So, this statement wants to convey the lower level needs should be attained, should be accomplished and should be fulfilled first. So, then the higher level needs becomes active. Otherwise, if the lower level needs are not fulfilled, the higher level needs remains inactive. So, this states that the lower level needs need to be fulfilled, need to be achieved and need to be accomplished. That is physiological needs and the safety or security needs. Then only the person can climb up the ladder, move to the your social needs, esteem or ego needs and then self-actualization or self-realization or self-fulfillment needs. So, this is until the lower level needs are satisfied, higher level needs remains inactive. Means, if the lower level needs are not fulfilled, the higher level needs remain in that position, remains inactive. If the lower level needs are satisfied and fulfilled, then only that higher level needs, that is esteem needs, self-actualization needs, becomes active. Then the person can climb up the pyramid or climb up the ladder. Now we move to the criticism of the Maslow's theory of human needs. Criticism means a remark or a review or a judgment. So this criticism is very of Maslow's theory is very helpful in analyzing, in understanding, in regulating the human behavior. So this Maslow's theory is very helpful in analyzing and reading and judging the human behavior, because as you know, human behavior is very much complex in nature. There are various and diverse needs, and human are very much driven forward through multiple motives, and these motives govern their behavior in situations, and for multiple motives they react differently in different sorts of situations. So you can see I've written here, it is very helpful, this Maslow's theory of motivations, Maslow's theory of human needs is very much helpful and assist in regulating, understanding and analyzing the human behavior and their motives. So it helps in analyzing and understanding human behavior, and also states that person, an individual person is very much propelled, pushed, directed and regulated by the multiple motives. So multiple motives means they are not having only single motive. They are having more than one or more than two. That is physiological needs, your safety needs, social needs. Means a person is regulated, driven, pushed forward by multiple motives. And why people behave differently in different sorts of situations. So why people behave, why they behave differently in the same sorts of situations. So it's very important. Criticism I have written here. The criticism of Maslow's theory of human needs states that it is very helpful. It is of assisting in nature, that how it helps to understand and analyze the human behavior, and therefore a people is pushed forward through multiple motives. It is governed through multiple motives. People does not only work for a single needs, they work for multiple motives such as physiological, safety and security, social, esteem needs, and how the people react to those situations in a different manner in the situations respectively. Now, we move next that this theory or this approach or this tenet or principle of Maslow's theories of human needs does not apply to only work life. It extends to all the situations of human life. So, this theory extends to all the areas, all the situations pertaining to human life. It does not only limit to work situation only. It does not limit to only work site such as factory or corporate organization. So, this Maslow's theory of human needs, it is not restricted to only work organization, work site only. It covers all the areas pertaining to a human needs. And this is also that this states also that this theory states that these unfulfilled needs pushes or inspires and motivates the employee to work harder to satisfy the need. And once the need is satisfied, it ceases to be a motivating factor. So you can look here, it also shows that people are motivated and inspired by the unsatisfied need. So once the needs are satisfied, this stops to be a motivating factor. This ceases to be a motivating factor. So it also shows that people are motivated by the unsatisfied needs, such as physiological needs are satisfied, then you move on to the safety needs. Then safety need is satisfied, then you move to the social needs. So if they are motivated by the unsatisfied needs, and when the needs are being satisfied, they no longer be a motivating factor. This ceases and stop to be motivating factor. So that the satisfied needs have no motivational value, no motivational power. And it also states that once the lower level needs, physiological needs, safety needs are satisfied, this becomes a very much no longer motivating factor, and these lower level needs are replaced by the higher level needs, such as esteem needs, self-actualization needs, and they govern the situation of the human, the needs. So it's written here, it also states that as lower level needs are fulfilled, higher level needs comes and replace those needs and then governs a person's situation or behavior. And one more criticism of Maslow's theories of human need is here, it is a complete theory. It is not a partial. It is a full and big theory of motivation, which is very much applicable to the human behavior, to the human situations, regarding the all five distinct categories. So it's written there, it is a complete theory of motivation because it recognizes and identifies the individual works to fulfill a variety of needs, from physiological to safety to social to esteem to self-actualization. So it fulfills the various sorts of needs of the human, and therefore it is a strong acceptance of the tenet. Of the tenet means the principle or the behavior, which is very much plural and dynamic. Means plural means it's not singular in nature. It consists of five different categories, and dynamism, it changes. It is sorts of flexible in nature. So one more time, that is assumption we have done, that it is classified into five distinct categories and five different theories. And as one level needs are satisfied, it ceases to be a motivating factor. It stops to be a motivating factor. And once the lower level needs are satisfied, the higher level needs comes there. And if the lower level needs are not yet satisfied, the higher level remains inactive. So satisfied needs no longer influences motivation. And this is the criticism which we have done. So all of you BSc students of class 12, do watch the video several and numerous times so as to catch the meaning, so as to grasp the meaning and concept clarity of it. And moreover, one more thing is that you have to read the textbook of BST very thoroughly and very in-depth, all the lines very carefully, minutely and attentively, so as to grasp the meaning, because during the exam hours, means the exams are approaching, you're all having MCQ questions, so you all be better prepared for it. You know that one question will have four sorts of options and you have to tick the correct one. So this is the conclusion of the chapter only. We'll do only the last portion, that is Herzberg two factor theory, that is motivational factors and the maintenance or hygiene factor. We'll do the two factor theory. After that we will do the emerging trends in human resources, because it is very a small chapter, so we can finish it. So you know your thing, what you have to, you know your homework assignment, and if any sorts of doubt or any sorts of problems arises, do proceed and text me, do revert back to me so I can provide you the required assistance.